Sometimes it's made for good. Sometimes. Hi, my name's Karen May and I'm the author of Thelma the Tiny Sea Turtle. It was first published in 2011 and I've recently re-released it, and it is now being published by a company called Feed A Read. I'll give you their details at the end. Thelma, the tiny sea turtle, lived in a beautiful, colourful coral reef in Coney Cove, in the middle of the Great Barrier Reef. She had been born one fine moonlit night on Bundaberg Bay, and now spent each day swimming happily among the corals with her best friend Lucy, a seahorse. This book is designed for children aged 5 to 8. It's an early reader, so you get to read it by yourself, and you have illustrations or pictures to help you and support the text for you. But life in the reef had its dangers too. Lucy had heard alarming stories about a devil scorpion fish. This is Lucy. She's a seahorse. That hid motionless in the dying reef, looking like a bit of dead coral. He would quickly dart from the rock to grab seahorses and swallow them down. And then there was the anglefish, a great grey, stalking fish that transfixed you with a blinding light. He lurks down in the dark glooms of the ocean depths. Thelma had heard tales of its flexible bones that allowed his jaws and stomach to expand, so it could eat turtles twice its own size. Thelma and Lucy were careful to always stay close to the reef, so they could quickly hide in the corals if any pouncing predators came along. But the stories that Thelma and Lucy feared most were the ones about Gerald, the great white shark. Gerald had lived in the reef for longer than anyone could remember. If you met Gerald when he was hungry, you would be gone. He would dart from his hiding place deep down in the coral cave and swim so fast no one had ever escaped from Gerald. Gerald's huge jaws were lined with razor-sharp teeth. Thelma had heard stories of Gerald swallowing whole turtles. Why, there was even a rumour that Gerald had snatched a porpoise from the surface and taken it down to the depths of his cave to devour it. The best way to avoid meeting Gerald was to always stay close in the cove and never swim across the bay, for it is in the deep, darker waters that Gerald loved best for hunting. Oh, that Gerald. One sunlit summer's day fills with curious snorkelers. Thelma and Lucy were swimming to and fro in the coral. They were playing hide and seek, and Thelma was searching for Lucy in the orange coral, for that is where she loved best to camouflage herself. Suddenly, Thelma felt herself being lifted up to the surface of the water. The next thing she knew, she was flapping helplessly in the bottom of a net, gasping for breath, her flippers stuck and tangled in the mesh. Mercifully, she soon found herself in water again, but it was so cold. She was surrounded by dark corners, and there was no welcoming corals to hide in. Where was Lucy? Thelma was frightened, very frightened. And then a sharp pain hit her in the neck. What is happening to me? Thought Thelma. Next, to her horror, she saw a huge, unfamiliar face so close, Thelma felt certain she was going to be eaten. Whew. What a story this is. Alexa, repeat song.
I'll repeat the song.